In this session, we'll see how to design a conveyor belt. You can see a typical belt conveyor arrangement with return idler, the carrier roller, and the bent pulleys. We'll just take a simple numerical and see how to design a simple conveyor belt and to find the transport capacity. So in this case, we have a salt paddy in which you need to transport the salt from that paddy to the source. We are given with the surcharge angle and the trough angle. The width of the belt is also given to you. You just need to find the transport capacity. Now you can see that based upon the type of material which we have a bulk material, we have a dry fine material, and the material is comparatively large. We have three different conditions for materials. So in this case, we'll see that salt comes under your bulk material and we go for surcharge angle of 20 degrees. Now, there is a formula to find the transport capacity in tons per hour. So QT is given. Now you can see that A is the cross-sectional area, V is the belt speed, gamma is the apparent specific gravity of material, and S is the coefficient by angle of incline or decline. Now, either we have a flat belt or a 3-trough belt or a 5-trough belt. So in the following slide, you can see that on the top, it's a flat belt and surcharge angle is nothing but the angle of the material to be transported. So you can see that if the salt is put on the conveyor belt, now you'll form as a heap. So the angle which is made to the conveyor belt is called its surcharge angle. Now coming to the troughed belt, you have a trough angle. Now for finding out the area, you are given with a formula. Now in this case, it has been particularly said that we have a 3 idler rolled trough and the trough angle is nothing but 10 degrees. The surcharge angle is 20. Now from this table number 5, we already found out that K is equal to 0.0945. So if you substitute, you will get the value of A. Now the belt speed is given as grains and other free flowing materials. Now for this case, the belt width is A and it can be 180 meters per minute. Now the apparent specific gravity of material, that is given as a salt and we are considering it as a broken rock. So the specific gravity is given to be 0.72 to 0.82. You can take a value in between that. We are taking a value of 0.75. Now the coefficient by angle, whether it is inclined or declined. So in table number 2, you can see that the maximum permissible is 10 degrees. Now the angle of incline is 10 degrees and the diminishing coefficient which we have found is 0.95. Now once you substitute in this equation, we'll get the transport capacity in tons per hour. So I hope everyone would have seen this preliminary example of how to calculate the transport capacity. In the next class, we'll be seeing with the power calculation.